Our next speaker is Major Jeff Johnson, and he's going to speak to you about gun safety.
Thank you, Ms. Heather. And first of all, let me thank you for coming out tonight. I greatly appreciate that. It tells me that you care enough to come out and listen to your candidates. And also thank you to the representatives of the Foothills Women's Republican. Thank you very much. Before we begin, I just want to talk to you about a couple of things. Again, I'm Jeff Johnson. I am a candidate for sheriff in this term. Firearms is one of my passions. I've been teaching firearms for the better part of 15 years. I've been involved in it for probably 18 years or better. I know there's a lot of people in this classroom tonight that's been through our firearms training. I know that there's some that's coming to our firearms training. So I don't want to let too many cats out of the bag, but I certainly look forward to having you come, and I've certainly enjoyed having those that's come out to join us. Let me ask you a question, just a quick show of hands. If you don't want to participate, that's fine as well. Anybody here not interested in toting a firearm? Anybody here a little apprehensive about toting a firearm? Just one? We need to change that. Let me ask you a question. I'll use Miss Karen up here for an example if she don't mind. Miss Karen, do you still have your parents with you? October 16th, 1991, and I hope this kind of resonates home to a lot of folks, because it doesn't just apply to your parents. This could be your children. This could be your aunts and uncles, brothers and sisters, grandchildren. October 16th, 1991, in a town called Tyleen, Texas. Does everybody know where I'm going with this?
Yes.
Lucas Cafeteria shooting. There was a lady by the name of Susanna Hubb. Susanna was a gun toter. Susanna had a gun in her pocketbook. She was meeting her mother and dad for lunch at a restaurant called Luby's Cafeteria. Yeah. Suzanne got concerned. She was afraid that she might get in trouble for toting a gun into the restaurant. She takes the gun out of her pocketbook and she leaves it in her vehicle.
Oops.
As she's in there with her 71-year-old father and her 67-year-old mother, a car crashes through the front of the building. Now, envision this. Envision you there with your family in Ryan's on a Sunday afternoon, and this happens. What's probably the first thing that's going to go through your mind? Got a car wreck, right? Mm-hmm. So what do you think people started doing? They started coming to the aid of this guy that they thought had had a wreck, but they were met with gunfire. Miss Susanna Huff testifies that she went to get her gun, but her gun was not there. During the ordeal, and different reports vary, but there's apparently reported that 23 people were shot and killed, with another 27 that were shot and wounded. Out of those 27 that were killed were Susanna Hupp's 71-year-old father and 67-year-old mother. So I say that just to kind of set the tone for you tonight. Does everybody here remember the Newtown, Connecticut shooting? Remember that? And Miss Ann Martin can tell you, we got inundated with permit applications, didn't we? I mean, everybody was coming in. I want to get my permit. I want to get my permit. Because, and even from our presidential candidates, you know, the federal government, we have a tendency to overreact sometimes. And whenever we have an unfortunate incident like that, what do you always hear on the news?
Gun control.
Gun control.
Not Ted Cruz.
Thank you. And I was joking around with Miss Ann one day, and I told one of the applicants to come in, I said, you know, I don't think the first criminals come in to get their application. And you can understand what I'm saying is that we always want to tend to penalize our law-abiding citizens when things like this happen. Mm-hmm. Now, I think we can all agree, do we have a gun control or a gun problem in the United States?
No.
Do we have an evil problem in the United States?
Yes.
Absolutely. I get folks that come in sometimes where I'm not going to carry. I just want to get my permit in case I need it. And I always try to share the Luby's Cafeteria shooting with them. What if Miss Susanna would have had a gun with her that day? You don't have any people in the restaurant that day? Roughly 140. Now, I'm not saying that they wanted a gun in that restaurant that day, but obviously if there was, somebody didn't take the initiative to respond to it. But how could we have reduced the casualties that day, potentially? So I just wanted to say that to set the tone, and I know I'm limited on time, but I want to talk about firearm safety with you for just a minute. The handout that you've got, firearm safety incorporates a lot of things. It incorporates fundamentals. how to use it, where to point it, how to squeeze the trigger, all these different things. But what I want to talk about is, say you're contemplating buying a gun. Is there a lot of different varieties?
Yes.
Absolutely. So I think we need to determine first, you know, what are we going to use it for? How many of you are play shooters, sport shooters? Is that the same kind of gun that you're going to have them for a home defense? Probably not. Now, what about personal defense? When we talk about personal defense, personal carry, we going to put a shotgun under our coat, Marcus, and go in Walmart? Probably not. So we need to be very mindful and cautious of when we're buying firearms, exactly what we want to buy. Now, what we teach, and ladies, you'll hear it, when we start talking about different type of platforms, weapon platforms, there's certain things as a revolver, and you have a picture of one on your handout. There's also semi-automatic pistols. What's the big difference between a semi-automatic pistol and a revolver? Come on, guys. Absolutely. What I was referred to is what? The old wheel gun, correct? Now, however, and I see a lot of people come to the range the first time, and I see a lot of ladies. We'll refer to ladies since this is a ladies' meeting. But we have a lot of ladies come to the range, and somebody else has bought them a gun. Why? Because that's what they felt like they needed to buy. And that's where I encourage you, find something that works for you. Now, I'm a big advocate of the wheel gun. Why do you think that is?
It works.
Simplicity. If I squeeze a trigger on a revolver, what's that cylinder going to do? It's going to rotate, and the hammer's going to fall on the chamber, correct? And if it doesn't go off, Mike, what am I going to do with a revolver?
Squeeze it again,
right? See, we trained it something in law enforcement years ago. When I first started, it was revolvers, and probably a lot of these other ones were revolvers. But we felt like we needed more ammunition. We felt like we needed more rounds. So we began to go to a magazine-fed weapon, semi-automatics. What comes with semi-automatic? What comes with a semi-automatic weapon?
A cammy?
Huh?
Is that what you're saying, cammy?
Potential for malfunctions, right? And I want you to think about this, ladies. Think about if you're in a high-stress situation, if you pull your gun out, and for some reason you're wrestling around, the subject hits the slide, takes it simply out of battery or something like that, then you've got what? You've got a malfunction. Now, in law enforcement, and those that send law enforcement in here can tell you, we teach and train every year our police officers how to clear malfunctions. There's malfunctions with a semi-automatic weapon that you're not going to encounter with a revolver. And even trained law enforcement officers under high stress situations, sometimes they have to stop and think, well, how do I clear this? How do I make this weapon function again? So when we teach the firearms and we teach the citizen classes like we do, we really encourage folks, number one, find the gun that works for you. All right, you best be up, Ms. Carey. All right, moving right along. Training, find you some good quality training. Look, it's out there, you may pay for it, but find you some good quality training. As I told you, I'm a candidate for sheriff. We are advocates of teaching firearms classes. We've got one coming up next week that I've already talked to some folks about. We believe in it. We believe an armed community is a safer community. We want you to partake in that. Understand the laws, all right? Not only will we teach you how to use a firearm, but we're going to teach you when you can use a firearm. Very important. We may shoot 100 on the range each and every week, but what if we don't know when we can squeeze that trigger? Is that a problem? Mm-hmm. I had a lady in the class one time, she asked me, she said, well, can I shoot somebody if they're standing in my living room? What is the answer to that?
Yes.
It is the end, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And we had a long discussion about that. Okay, what if it is somebody that's coming in a violent, tumultuous manner to do you harm?
Yes.
Probably so. But what if it's a special needs adult that's down the road and he's just wandered into your living room? So there is no black or white answer to this thing. But if you're going to be a responsible gun owner, if you're going to carry it, you need to know the laws. And again, just trying to make this quick, be careful with your carry, be careful with your storage. Make sure that you have it in the, but be mindful of who's coming in your home. How many of you have small children, grandchildren? How many of you may have a special needs person in your home? You need to be careful how you How do you store your gun? Does that mean we lock it up and safe? I think you've got to find that balance that works for you. What's accessible, but yet what is still secure? So again, please, if I can help you, you've got my information on there. If you're interested in the class, I know I've already talked to a couple, please feel free to send me an email. Love to have you. We enjoy with the sheriff. This is something that we've worked on for the past several years. We've had a lot of classes, and a lot of you can attest to that. We have a good time. We try to keep it safe. We try to keep it enjoyable. And for the most part, if you're not a gun person, when you come to the class, you'll probably be after the class. But is there any questions I could answer for anybody? Yes, ma'am, Ms. Sheriff.
This magazine says that if you are stopped for like a traffic ticket or whatever, that you should get your permit out and show it to the officer. I mean, he doesn't even know if I have a gun. So why do I need to show him?
You don't. There's no law that says that you have to tell them that you've got a gun in the car. There's no law that says you have to show them your permit. I can tell you from a personal perspective, is when I used to stop cars and vehicles, that if I walked into a car and someone said, you know, sir, I've got a gun in the car, I always appreciated that. It always built a little bit of a rapport. But Ms. Sheriff, you're under no obligation to do so. Any other questions? All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.